Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. Today, we invited Marcin to come in to talk to us a little bit about additive manufacturing. And Marcin, thanks for joining us, appreciate it. Before we start, can we just, who are you, what do you do?
Hey Jay, thank you for having me. I'm Marcin Bauza and I'm heading a Zeiss Additive Manufacturing Process and Control Group. And our main focus is to help the additive industry and in general industry to really make the additive dream become true.
Awesome, okay, additive dream to come true is a big statement because to be honest with you, when I think of additive, I don't think too much of it, right? I think of nerds in the basement, hacking on code and making little toys. I always question myself, what does Zeiss have to do with that? So can you tell us a little bit about what additive is and how are we involved in it?
So first of all, additive is just another technique of creating parts. And you're absolutely right, the beginning was a number of nerds in the basements and creating all kind of strange machines. However, the technology improved significantly. And now there's a next generation of engineers who are thinking, okay, this is good enough. I could use this to produce my parts. I could make a more sophisticated shapes. I could create a more sophisticated materials. So plastics are interesting. However, metals are even more. So now if I can do metal printing or ceramics, I can create airfoils, I can create automotive components, or I can create a medical parts that really opens the door for more possibilities than it was.
I had no idea we can 3D print ceramic? Really?
Absolutely.
That's crazy. All right, so we can, new materials, so now when I think of additive manufacturing, I think, all right, you can create internal structures. Really all you need to measure an additive manufacturing part is one of these metrotoms, right? A CT scanner, and then you can get inside there and that's it. So why do we even spend more time? We'll just sell them give them a solution of a metrotom and be done with it, right? Is there more to it than that?
So you're partially right. And the challenge is that most people think that, yeah, I need a CT to do some measurements and I need a CT to find out if there are porosity inside or cracks. However, the problem is you really need to understand the entire process, starting from powder to in process when you're measuring every layer when part is being built, and then doing analysis of pulse in terms of form factors like CT or materials. So you need SEMs, you need a light microscope. So this is much broader aspect. I give you example. For example, we had a customer who had a cracked part. And first they say, okay, cracked is a heat problem. But then when we zoom in and we look into this, we've seen, okay, maybe there are different materials. We did analysis, EDS analysis with SEM, and we found, oh, there is a little particle inside this part that is a different material than the rest. That tells you that, okay, I have a problem with a powder. My powder is dirty. There is something else in it, even though I bought a clean batch. And you can start building a story of how you can help your process.
Oh, interesting. Okay, so for me, again, I go right to the end product because that's what I'm used to with, I guess, what we call subtractive now. But additive, yeah, the powder, means a lot. We have those equipment. You said things like scan electron microscopes and microscopes, and those are fine and dandy. I know we have those equipments, but do we have any knowledge to back that up, or is it just, you know, we have these solutions and good luck?
So Zeiss does have a lot of bits and pieces, or had before, on the material science since the beginning of microscope. We've been involved to evolve this technology. We also very good on the metrology side, but you're absolutely right. Additive has a very different needs. And because you're creating a material properties at the same time when you're creating a shape. So you have to connect those dots. And to do that very well, about a year ago, we started a special cooperative research agreement together with Department of Energy in US and Oak Ridge National Laboratory. And through this agreement, with both parties really focusing on additive. So Oak Ridge is well known for extremely well understanding of additive processes and metals and plastics and so on. And we have all the technology to identify problems. And together we're working to create a seamless solutions for industry. So I want to make sure that industry can clearly follow the steps, what they're supposed to inspect, how they're supposed to inspect, what this data means, how this data needs to be connected between the process steps. So then they have a very quick understanding of what is the end goal.
So I think I'm hearing that we're creating some best practices with a real research partner that's trying to move the technology forward. So someone that's just getting into it or someone that needs to go deeper into it can have some equipment and have some expertise, right?
Yeah, I give you one example. So just to see how challenging the problem is, I talk to a lot of customers and I often hear from aerospace that it may take a few years to develop a single recipe for one part. So when you think about it, several years, yes. And it may cost several $1 million. So now when you think about it, oh, additive is fast and quick, and now I'm telling you several years before you can really put the part in the plane. Yeah. That's true. So part of a problem is with connecting those dots, we are looking to reduce that time for recipe development from years to days or short weeks.
Oh, wow.
So that will be a significant benefit for the industry. We're already showing a first cases on this where we took a steps that normally would take almost a year and we reduced that to a few days.
Wow.
And that's a very rapid process. This is something that industry really will benefit, and this will enable the industry to take the next step to really put the additive from R&D or experimentation to true mass production.
Yeah, it sounds like it's definitely taking an idea, a core concept, what seems like a novel idea, and really getting it to a place where it's implementable in everyday production. So that sounds like a lot of work. Sounds like there's a lot of topics that we can dive into. There's a lot of core competencies. I would really like to go further into some of these different topics. Is it all right if we invite you or someone from your team back to, as we figure out which ones to drill down and maybe do some future video blogs?
Absolutely, that would be a pleasure.
Perfect, awesome. Marcin, thanks for your time, appreciate it. And for you out there, thanks for joining us. Please continue to stay safe and stay healthy. And thank you for joining us this and every Thursday. But for now, see you later.